Welcome back to my channel Needle Lace. Today I'm going to share with you all how to do this motif. This has a very nice finish also. You can make multiple motifs and join them, or you can add each motifs for tablecloth and join them also. It looks good. I'm going to share with you all stepwise in my following videos how to do this. This is done again using only thread and needle. I'll be back with you all in my following videos stepwise how to do it. Let's begin with this motif. Let's work with a ring of 25 petals. Now wrap the thread around your finger. Insert the needle, and the back part of the thread should be wrapped anti-clockwise and pull. This will be the first knot. Leave some space. Insert the needle again. Back part of the thread wrapped anti-clockwise and pulled. And this loop should be pulled. This is the first loop. Now I'm going to work with the second loop. Similarly, we have to continue with 25 petals, elongated petals, to complete the first row. Work with 5 petals. Similarly, 20 petals have to continue to complete this row. I'm going to show you some more, 2 or 3, and then can get back to you when I'm doing the 25th petal. This is it, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And we have to continue with 25 petals. I'll get back to you when I'm doing the 25th petal. This is the 25th petal that I'm doing now to complete this ring. We will have to pull this thread to form a ring. And we can lock it here by placing a knot. This is how it looks. This looks
overlapped, but when we are working with the second row, this will come into a neat shape. The second row will be only knots over. All the loops, and next over that we'll have to place beehives. Now let's leave this thread. Later on that can be cut. Now let's start here with a new thread. I'm adding a new thread here. And this is how we are going to work with the second row. And over this, after this row is completed, this will form a neat pattern and we can place beehives over it. As you can see, this is coming into a new neat shape now. Insert the needle inside the loop, wrap the thread anti-clockwise and place a knot, and keep the distance very near so that all the loops should be placed next to each other. That is, the knot should hold them in place. This is how it looks. This is how it looks, and I will get back to you when I reach the starting point again. Now the second row is completed. And now we have to place, for the third row we have to form beehives. 3, 4, 5, 6 rows we have to place beehives. Now insert the needle as I'm showing. This will be the first beehive. Place the needle in the next space. Wrap the thread again anti-clockwise and pull. hope it is clearly visible. This row and the next two rows also will be worked over these again to form the small beehive patterns. In my previous videos also I had shown how to form beehive pattern. You can follow those also. This is to be completed and I'll get back to you when I have completed the fourth or fifth round, and I'll show you how to form this last row.